Hi, I'm Swarup Patel, Course Instructor for Geotechnical Engineering 2. In this presentation, we will find out what do we mean by angle of reinforce and what is factor of safety. Here in this figure, we can see that the dry sand is being poured on a horizontal surface. So when it is poured, it will try to occupy the shape in the form of a cone. The angle between this horizontal surface and the inclination is referred to as the angle of repose. And this angle of repose varies between 0 to 90 degrees. And the grains are aligned along this inclined plane due to the frictional contact. So there exists grain to grain frictional contact between all the particles of the sand. But when the wet sand is poured on a horizontal surface, we can see that due to presence of water, a thin film is developed around the particles. The surface tension of this film of water holds the grain particles together. But whereas if water is still more added to the same sand, it becomes saturated and water completely surrounds all the grains and it eliminates the grain to grain contact which was existing in the dry sand. Due to this, the sand will flow. Here we can see the angle of repose being shown for three different materials. One is fine sand, second is coarse sand, and the third one is angular pebble. For fine sand, the angle of repose is 35 degrees. For coarse sand, it is more than that, which is 40 degrees. And for angular pebbles, it is more than coarse sand and it is 45 degrees. That means smooth rounded sand grains can't be piled in a steep slope, whereas we can see that for angular slopes, we can find the steep slope being occupied by it and it is 45 degrees. Here we can see that there are two slopes. Beta represents the slope angle and this is the angle of repose. And in this figure we can see that the slope angle is less than angle of repose, hence slope remains stable. So this is what is the slope which the soil can occupy without failure. So when the slope angle is less than angle of repose, it remains in stable position. In the second sketch, we can see that the angle of repose is less than the slope angle. So hence there will be failure of the soil mass. So the care should be taken such that the slope angle remains less than the angle of repose for it to be stable. In this figure we can see a soil mass along the slope angle beta. W is the weight of the soil mass which is acting downwards, and the driving force will make the soil to move downwards, and there will be opposition being offered to this driving force by the resisting force. And the same figure can be seen here. W is the weight of the soil which is acting in downward direction, and its components are M and T. Gravity will allow the soil mass to flow downwards along the slope, and that is what is referred to as the driving force. Your driving force is the gravity. Whereas the resisting force which acts opposite to this gravity is due to the soil strength. And this soil strength is a function of cohesion and friction. Cohesion is the ability of the particles to attract and hold each other together. So due to cohesion, soil particles will remain in certain slope angle. And internal friction is the friction between the grains within the material, and this also helps to hold the particles together. So when cohesion and friction is greater, the resistance offered to the driving force is more. Now we'll find out how this slope angle affects both driving and resisting forces. Here there are three figures. In the first figure we can see that there is low slope angle. In second, the slope angle is greater than the first one, and for the third one there is very high slope angle, that is beta. W is the weight of the soil acting downwards, and its components are N and T. N is the normal force component and T is the tangential force component. In the first figure, the magnitude of N is greater, as we can see from the length of this arrow. In the second sketch, it is smaller than the first one, and in the third, it is still more lesser. Similarly, the magnitude of tangential force is less in the first figure, it is greater than the first one in the second, and it is still more higher in the third figure. This indicates that with the decrease in the value of N, the frictional component also decreases. Hence, the resisting force will decrease, due to which there will be failure of the soil mass. So here we can see with the increase in the slope angle, the magnitude of N goes on decreasing, due to which the resistance offered will also decrease. Hence, there will be slope failure. Similarly, with increase in the value of tangential component, as we can see with the length of this arrow, here the magnitude of T is increasing. So with increase in T, there will be also decrease in the frictional component, due to which the slope will not be stable at very high slope angle, that is beta. Now we find out how to get the value of factor of safety. We know that the factor of safety has to be greater than 1 for the slope to be stable. So we will have to check how much is the factor of safety, and accordingly preventive measures will have to be taken. For first type of soil, that is cohesionless soil, factor of safety is given by shear strength divided by shear stress. Shear strength is denoted by tau F, and developed shear stress, that is tau D. Tau D is the driving force and tau F is the resisting force. If resisting force is higher, factor of safety will be more, that means it will be greater than 1. Similarly, if tau D is less, if the driving force is less, Fs will be more, because factor of safety is inversely proportional to driving force, that is driving stress. So factor of safety for cohesionless soil is written as tan phi divided by tan beta, where phi is the angle of internal friction and beta is the slope angle. If the slope is completely submerged, that means it is a submerged slope, factor of safety also can be calculated using formula tan phi divided by tan beta. So this indicates that factor of safety will remain same, except that the value of phi has to be determined for submerged condition. So here in this figure, the direction of tau D, that is driving force, is shown in downward direction, and the resisting force, that is tau F, is shown in upward direction, and beta is the slope angle. If the water table is at the surface and its seepage is parallel to the slope, Fs can be calculated again using the same formula, that is shear strength divided by the shear stress, that is tau D. Tau F is gamma dash into tan phi divided by gamma saturated into tan beta. Here we can take this value as gamma saturated if the slope is saturated, and we can consider gamma if it is not. For C5 soil, factor 50 again given by the same formula, that is shear strength versus shear stress. Shear strength is given by C plus sigma tan phi, where sigma is gamma dash into z into cos square beta and tan phi as it is, divided by shear stress, that is gamma saturated into z into cos beta into sin beta. Here we can consider gamma saturated if it is saturated, otherwise we will have to consider bulk liquid, that is gamma. In this formula, C is Kolchin, gamma dash is submerged unit weight, and Z is the depth of the failure plane from the ground surface. Now we'll go through the simple problems which were given in the textbook Bhurmia. A long natural slope of Kolchin-less soil is inclined at 12 degrees to the horizontal. So that means here beta is 12 degree. Angle of internal friction phi is 30 degree. Determine the factor of safety of the slope. If the slope is completely submerged, what will be the change in the factor of safety? The formula for finding factor of safety is shear strength versus shear stress. Shear strength is given by tan phi divided by tan beta. Here instead of beta they have used letter I, so I is nothing but the slope angle. Phi is 30 degree which is given, beta, that is I, is equal to 12 degree. So once we substitute, we get factor of safety equal to 2.72. So this is what is the first unknown term which we have to find out, and in the second statement, they have asked us to find again the factor of safety provided the slope is completely submerged. When the slope is completely submerged, we have to replace unit weight gamma by gamma dash, because gamma dash represents the submerged unit weight. So we will write F equal to gamma dash z cos square beta, that is I, into tan phi divided by into z into sin beta into cos beta, which will be written as equal to tan phi divided by tan beta. So once we substitute the value of phi equal to 30 degree and beta, that is I, equal to 12 degree, we get factor of safety equal to 2.72. Here we can see from the first and second calculation that the factor of safety will remain same, except that phi has to be determined under submerged condition. Next problem. A long natural slope of sandy soil with phi, that is angle of internal friction, equal to 25 degree is inclined at beta equal to 10 degree to the horizontal. The water table is at the surface and the seepage is parallel to the slope. If the saturated unit weight of the soil is 19.5 kN per cubic meter, find the factor of safety of the slope. So, factor of safety is given by gamma dash into tan phi divided by gamma saturated into tan beta, that is I. Gamma submerged is gamma saturated minus gamma W. Gamma saturated is given as 19.5, gamma W is 9.81 kN per cubic meter, that is unit weight of water. Tan phi, phi is 25 degree. Gamma saturated is given as 19.5 into tan beta, that is I, which is equal to 10 degree. With this we get factor of safety equal to 1.31. So factor of safety is greater than 1, hence it is stable. Next problem. A long natural slope in a C5 soil is inclined at 12 degree to the horizontal. The water table is at the surface and the seepage is parallel to the slope. If a plane slip has developed at a depth of 4 meters, find the factor of safety. Here the soil is C5 soil. So the value of C and value of phi are given. C is 8 kN per square meter and phi is 22 degree. Saturated unit weight is given as 19 kN per cubic meter. With this we need to find out what is factor of safety. Factor of safety is shear strength divided by shear stress. Shear strength is given as C plus gamma dash z cos square I tan phi divided by gamma saturated into z into cos beta into sin beta. C is 8 plus gamma dash is the submerged unit weight, that is gamma saturated minus gamma W. Gamma saturated is 19, gamma W, that is unit weight of water, is 9.81 into z is 4 meter into cos square beta, that is 12 degree, into tan phi, that is 22 degree, divided by gamma saturated, that is 19, into z is 4, into cos beta, where beta is 12 degree, into sin beta, again the value of beta is 12 degree. So once we calculate here, we get as 1.44. Thank you.